An underground car park has a system that checks the height of vehicles. A vehicle can be no higher than 1.8 meters to enter the car park. The system also counts the number of vehicles that have entered the car park, so that it can display how many parking spaces are still available. Each parking space has a red and a green light above it. If a car is parked in the parking space, only the red light is on. Otherwise, only the green light is on. Sensors and a microprocessor are used to control the system. Question 8 says, complete the table to identify the suitable sensor for each part of the system. Here we are given a table containing tasks, and we have to write the sensor that corresponds to each task. Each of these tasks corresponds with a part of the question. For example, the first task, check if a vehicle is too high, corresponds with this part of the question, no higher than 1.8 meters. For this task, a car could be passing through a gateway. The gateway could be filled with invisible infrared lasers. When a car passes through the lasers would be interrupted, and the infrared sensors on the other side would detect which lasers have been interrupted, thereby determining the height of the car. So here we would put an infrared sensor. The second task says to count the vehicles entering the car park. To count how many vehicles enter the car park, we could add a pressure sensor at the gateway, and the car will press down on the pressure sensor when it goes through. The pressure sensor would only activate on very heavy objects, so if people walked through, it would not detect them. Let's go ahead and write down pressure sensor. The last task says, check if a vehicle is parked in a parking space. Under each parking space, we could also place a pressure sensor, or on each parking space, we could also put infrared detectors. If we wanted to be a bit more creative, since cars are made out of metal, we could use a magnetic field sensor to detect if cars have entered the parking space and if they leave the parking space. So let's go ahead and write down magnetic field sensor. Question B says, describe how the sensor and the microprocessor are used to display the red or green light above the parking space. To answer this question, we're going to draw a small diagram representing how the data gets from the sensor to the microprocessor and the action that the microprocessor takes. Initially, we have a magnetic field sensor that is going to be placed on each parking space. This field sensor will detect if a car enters the parking space and when a car leaves the parking space. It will send an analog current over to an ADC. This analog current will be converted by the ADC into a digital value, which will be sent over to the microprocessor. The microprocessor will compare the value from the magnetic field sensor to its stored value. Then one of three actions will happen. Either it detects if a car is pulled into the parking space, or it detects that there is no car in the parking space, or there is no change, which means that a car is currently there and hasn't moved, or there is no car in the parking space and no car has entered yet. The question says that we have a red and a green light. When a car enters the parking space, the red light should go on and the green light should go off. When the car leaves the parking space, the green light should go back on and the red light should go off. If there is no change, then no action should happen. This process is continuous, meaning that it repeats over and over again, as this magnetic field sensor is always sending data to the microprocessor. Let's now go ahead and answer the question. We're going to do this using the SCAR acronym, which is something we've discussed in a past video. Sensor, ADC, microprocessor, comparison between stored values, action from result of comparison, and repeats. Starting off, we can mention that the sensor sends data to the ADC and then to the microprocessor. The sensor sends data to the microprocessor and is converted from analog to digital using an ADC. The next thing we want to mention is the comparison between the stored values and the action from the result of the comparison. We can say that the data from the sensor is compared to stored values. And we now want to mention that there are three possible actions, meaning there must be three possible outcomes from its comparison. If the data is greater than the stored values, a signal is sent to turn the red light on and the green light off. That is our first outcome. The second outcome is going to be when the car exits, and the action is that the red light turns off and the green light turns on. And our last step says that we need to mention it is a continuous process. In other words, the process repeats. One thing we could mention is the process of how the lights are turned on and turned off. An electromechanical device known as an actuator is used to turn the lights on and off, and is used in most systems to turn a digital signal into an analog output. But there we go, that is this question complete.